I just don't get this, man. I have a heart. Okay. Hands. Two hands. Praying hands. Giving hands. Floppy hands. I got bananas. Bananas? Really? Bananas? Oranges? A strawberry? I even have two Bibles.
Hey, Robin, what you doing up there?
You know, Brad, I'm not really sure. I have, like, all these strange things. I have a door. I even have an eyeball. I have two eyeballs. I mean, you know, it is so weird because Nate told me that all of these things, if I could put them together, would give me an idea of something that came out of the resurrection. I don't get it. I'm really trying. So he said to, if I needed to read Acts chapter 2, verse 42. So I'm going to do that. The fellowship of the believers. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to fellowship, to the breaking of bread and to prayer. Praying hands. Everyone was filled with awe at the many wonders and signs performed by the apostles. All the believers were together and had everything in common. They even sold property and possessions to give to anyone who needed. Every day they continued to meet together in the temple courts. They broke bread in their homes and they ate together with glad and sincere hearts, praising God and enjoying the favor of all the people. And the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved. I think I have it. I think I figured it out. This is it. There's a heart. They had great love for each other, which came out of the resurrection. See, Jesus died on the cross for them and was risen from the dead, so they knew he loved them so they could love each other. I'm going to put the heart right up here. Oh my goodness. I put it on upside down, I think. But now I have it. I know how this puzzle goes together. They had all kinds of hands. Their hands were used for all kinds of stuff. First, they had praying hands. They prayed with each other and for each other. They had giving hands. They stretched out and reached out to other people. That's what they did. They used their hands for Jesus. Oh my goodness, I got this. I got this puzzle. Nate is going to be so proud of me because I'm going to know what came from the resurrection. Look at that. They had hands. And you know what else they did? They gave. They gave their possessions. They gave money to people who were in need. They didn't just go out and do silly things. They helped people when people needed it. So they gave gifts to people. I think that's so cool. I could do that. I wrote some cards this week for some people. That's a way to use my giving hands and to give to people from my heart. Oh my goodness. And then, look, the Bibles. They use their hands to hold the Bibles and to read. They use their eyes to see others and to read the Bible. That's what they did. I so get this, Nate. I have it all down. This is so cool. But now I just have bananas, oranges, and strawberries. But I have it figured out. They all go down here. I know what it's about because the Bible said that they ate together. They ate all kinds of stuff together. And I bet that Nate knew in the Bible they ate a lot of fruits and vegetables and stuff. And so that's why he gave me all these bananas and this orange and these cool strawberries that look like teardrops. And oh my goodness, look! It's the church. It's not a building. It's who we are. It's us giving out and being the church to other people. That's what happened in the Bible. That's what happened because of the resurrection. People were able to come together and pray. They had fellowship. That's a bunch of fellas in the same ship. Get along. That's what they do if they tarry very long. They helped each other. They worshiped with each other to God. They ate together. They praised God together, and they shared. And you know what? When they did that, they became the church. And when they became the church, other people who were unbelievers, they began to believe because they saw Jesus. And so they started asking Jesus into their heart. Then they could take their heart, and because of their love for Jesus, they would use their hands to pray and to give and to read, their eyes to read scripture and to see needs and to help others. They just kept helping and happening over and over and over again until the church multiplied. That's what happened because of the resurrection when Jesus was risen from the dead. Isn't that so cool? Not only did he love us enough to die for us and give us life in ourselves, but he asked us to share that with everyone else. So this week, kiddos, I want you to find a way that you can serve somebody else and you can show them the love of Jesus. You can reach out to them. You can use your hands to pray and read the Bible and your eyes to see others and to read the Bible. And you can give and you can eat together and praise the Lord for all the things that he's done for you. That's my challenge. Text me. Get my number from your parents. Text me what cool thing you did for somebody else this week. God loves you. I love you. Be the church.